and you will be getting a time to clarify your doubts. And today we are going to discuss about the original social work. What is the social work? It is a widely discussed topic at present, right? Because we can see in our society, anywhere we go, we hear some words that I am a social worker, I am a social worker. Sometimes the politician used to say they are social worker. And if somebody is helping any other people, they also call social workers. If anybody is giving, what is that? Help to a patient at the hospital, they also claim that they are social workers. And apart from this term social workers, what we are up to? Actually, we are known as professional social workers. And there's a big difference between the social work and the professional social work. Okay. And what are the things which differentiate the professional social work and other field of social work? That are the things we are going to discuss now. And as we know, social work is a special kind of curriculum. And okay, yes, it, now in India, especially in the professional social work, is a newly originated. It is a large, what is it? Long history back, but the people are recognizing social work professionals nowadays because it is a less recognized profession nowadays. That is one of the reason also we are facing now to address the professional social work. Okay, this is about some introduction, and before we are going to learn about the professional social workers, we should know about its history. And in the history of social work, we are going to study in another session, very large. But some other terms which is related to the professional social work. Okay, and that is what I was telling in the beginning. Some persons are called social workers if they are helping others. Politicians are called social workers. They themselves called as social workers. Yeah. And now, therefore, we should analyze the different terms, okay? And before going to study about the professional social workers, that is what we are going to study now. And in the first textbook, you will be having four textbooks, right? No? Okay, and first we will discuss about the history of social workers. Just like in the third textbook and fourth textbook, then we will come to the first and second. Okay. Okay. First, we should learn about the concept of social work. Okay. And now I am going to deal with the concept of social work first, then different methods of social work, then its international level concept, its purpose, its objectives. Then we'll go to development of social work at two different regions. Okay, that is what I'm just categorizing this one. So before going to learn about social workers, there are some terms like charity. You know, if the social work, if you are tracing the history of social work, we must study about the charity, voluntary actions, Shramadan, social service, some other terms right now. That is a very important part while studying the professional social workers. And first of all, we can learn about charity. What is mean by charity? My question is it the charity is a social work? That is a question we are asking long before also, right now. Some people are doing charity work and they are claiming they are social workers. And my question is, what is charity? And how is it related to any relation between this charity and professional social workers? Okay. And what is charity? Charity is what is just an almsgiving process. Right now, just giving a temporary relief to a person in need of help. Right. That is what is charity. Charity means just we are giving, we are helping the people, those who are in need. It is for a, just for a temporary relief in our society or in our community. Okay, we used to help the people, right? No, we used to provide what is the money or dress or any other medicinal help to the people as a part of our charity, right? And my question is it called as is it called as professional social work? No, because what is professional social workers? Professional social workers means just helping the people to help themselves, and also it is focusing a permanent social and personal development of a person right now. And what is happening in the charity work is charity work. And the person in need is always a dependent. What is of professional social workers? We are making a people or a person in need as empowered. We are encouraging, or we are supporting the person to lead a stable life. But in the case of charity, we are just they are just what is attaining their temporary relief only. But in the case of professional social workers, we are giving a permanent relief or permanent what is a satisfaction to a person in need. Therefore, we cannot call this charity as professional social workers. Okay, that is the term we are confusing nowadays. That is people are doing charity is called as social work, professional social workers. No, there is not what we do, what we discussed just before, right? Okay, then we can see that every religion, when we trace the history, every religion enjoys the charity. Okay, every religion enjoys their spiritual life by helping others. Just for example, in the religions of Hinduism promote charity. It is given one who gives, they shine more. That's a belief in Rig Veda, that one who gives more, they shine more. And when we comes to the Christianity, Christian religion, okay, and the Old Testaments give a great trust on charity. No, there is a 10 testimonies there. In there, it is according to Jews, this clearly says that in the brotherhood of the love to the brotherhood, for the love to neighbors means we should help our neighbors, those who are in need. Okay, and that religion enjoys, the Christian religion also enjoys the charity. And when we come to Islam religion, also according to the Islam religion, is the ones who give, the helping others is a prayer to God. Okay, and they are. And the people belongs to the Islam religions, they are giving the fixed percentage of the wealth to the needy people as a charity work. And when we call as zakat or hadiyat, these are all examples. Okay, for this part of their help to the people. And this is about the charity. Okay, and we should understand what is mean by charity first. And when it comes to the voluntary action, what is voluntary work or voluntary action? In our society, we used to give voluntary service. Okay, no? And we used to service. And what is mean by that? Is it called as a professional social work? Or is it called as a social work? Just think about what is, just analyze what is voluntary work. We all have done a lot of voluntary work to our neighbor, or to the society, right? And what is a voluntary work? When we what is look at definitions of this voluntary action or voluntary work. It is just an action, okay, which is done by people voluntarily, okay, on their own will, without any force, without any reward, without any material reward, okay, without an expectation. People are voluntarily rendering their help, okay, their support. Okay. Is it clear now?
Yes, it's clear now. Better. Thanks.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. And we can have a discussion. Okay. No issue. It is not just like a one-way communication. You can also ask, and we can clarify the doubts, and we can go there. That is the process of social work. Okay. Because we are dealing with the society. After completing the course, also we are going to enter the society with our special knowledge and skill. Okay. And when we analyze the what is the characteristics of voluntary action, it is a sense of social concern. Okay, we can see that all the people are not we can see our society. All the people they are not ready to give the help, support to society. Relate to the social concern and the faith in the virtue of the people. And the virtue of the service to those humanity, and it is related to the virtue of service to the mankind. Okay, therefore, voluntary action is also another kind of giving help and support to society, and it is the stage we have to discuss. Is it a professional social work? The voluntary action is a professional social work. Is it for social work? Little confusion, no? Right? No? And here it is an important what is the definition and different techniques and methods of social work. We cannot call this voluntary action as a professional social work. Okay. Because what is professional social work? What are the aims of professional social work? As we are already discussed just before, right now. And comparing this one, we cannot call this what is a voluntary action as a social work. But when we trace the history, when the development of professional social work is still now, this voluntary action charity has also an important part in the for the development of professional social work. But they are not. We cannot call this voluntary action as a process social work. Okay.
So
the next term is Sramadhan.
So, what about the payment involved in this voluntary versus professional social work? Because I see social work as a profession as like another job and get the payment.
Yeah.
But voluntary is something like, as you said, it's some kind of service without any intention of payment.
Yes. That is why that is the question I have raised here, because those who are doing voluntary work, they used to claim that they are social workers. Okay, and just for make it clear the sentence about the two, personal social work and voluntary action. That is why we are going to we are going to discuss the voluntary social work. And we cannot call this voluntary work as a social work, because professional social workers has its own values and its own objectives in the society. But we will study, we will discuss just a little later. That is why we are going to study about these terms. Some people may misunderstand or misconcept about the voluntary action. They will claim that the voluntary action as a professional social work. That is why voluntary action is not a professional social workers. Okay, because in the professional social workers, our main objective is the development, social development. Okay, and without expecting anything from the if it is a paid, but it is not making people more dependent. Okay. And we are entering into the society We are helping the people, we are supporting the people with a special knowledge, and we are getting a specialized practice and a technical skill. We are going a systematic way to help the people to help others. Okay, that's why this voluntary action and professional social work is different. Okay, then we come to paid agent. It is to we will discuss later on, but just for a clarification, is the professional social workers, it is a professional service. Okay, we are in the definition itself, it is saying it's a professional service. Therefore, our aim is to help the people to help themselves. Just like empowerment of the people to addressing the injustice in the community and making an equivalence. Okay, and there is an equivalence in the society. And also, it is a professional service, and providing the service, we are paid. Okay. Then next one is Shramadan. What's mean by Shramadan? Shramadan, just for example, Shramadan is in the NSS or NCC, National Cadet Corps, no, at the school level and at the college level, as a part of our club. Okay, we used to help the society. We used to work for the poor people and other society members, for the betterment of the society, for concerning in the better development of society. We used to do a manual work, just work, making the road, or clearing the drainage system, or any cleaning, making a hygiene system in the society. Just manual work. Its aim is to getting some concrete work to be accomplished. Yes, we are rendering our manual work for the society, for the betterment of the society. That is a Shramadan. And we can definitely say that it is not a social work. It is only a manual work giving to the society or community right now. Therefore, we cannot call this Shramadan as a professional social work. Because in the social work, means it is a special kind of activity, okay, requiring a body of knowledge and a skill, rendering our effective service to the society. But in the case of Shramadan, Shramadan is just a manual labor, okay, giving to the society, just like a clean drainage or making a road system, means manually, just for an induction to help the society. Okay, therefore we cannot call this Ramadan also a social work. Why we are discussing this term is that before going to study about process social work, we should learn about these terms. Then only we can clearly clarify our duties, our responsibility towards the society as a profession. Okay, that's why we are discussing this term. And we can see some examination. It is asking that what is Shramadan, how it is related to social work, is it in a relation with the social work, what is charity. Okay, this sometime we can see some questions in the previous examination about is it charity is a social work, something like that. Therefore, we should present nicely. These are the reason why these terms or this work is not a professional social work. And the next three terms are, we are going to discuss about social movement, social reform, and social network. Okay. What we study, we already discussed about voluntary action, charity, and Shramadan. And next we are just going to study about social movement, social reform, and social network. Okay, what is mean by social movement? We are a victim of number of movements, right? Not social movements nowadays. in our state and in our country also, right now in the world also. What is meant by that? A social moment. I think some of you also be a part of that right now in our society, in our area, region also. We have also, what is it, have some kind of experience to be shared, being a part of any movement, any social movement right now. What's the name of a social movement and social reform? Okay, first, what is social movement? It is, we are familiar to the term social movement, right? What is social movement? We can say that a social movement is a deliberate and collective endeavor to promote a change, okay, in any direction and by any means, not excluding any kind of violence, revolution, okay, right now. It's a deliberate and collective effort, okay, a deliberate collective effort endeavor to promote a change in the society in any direction. Okay, means it is just addressing in the any discontent in the society and making a change in a what is a any direction in the society without involving any kind of violence. Okay, any kind of revolutions. Okay, right. This is what about a social movement. And can you say any example of social movement? There are a lot of social movements right now. Person movement is there, environmental movement is there, social movement is there. Are a lot of examples there, right? We can discuss, we can differentiate the movement in different categories. Okay, social movements are there. And when we study the history of India, we can see a lot of social movements happens. Okay, and we just analyze, we'll just take a one moment and analyze what is the reason why this movement has happened, what is the result of this, what is the objective of that, and what is the after that moment. Okay, and these are all familiar terms, that is fine. And my question is that in the professional social work curriculum, is there any relationship between social movement and professional social work or social work? That is our aim to find, our aim to find out the relationship. Is there any relationship between social movement and the social work? Yes, we can say right now it is highly significant. The social movements are highly significant to social work. Okay, it is related. It is highly related to social work. Why? What is the aim of social movement? Means just to make a positive change in the society. For why? Addressing the discontent in the society, which is existing in the society, which is affecting in the normal life of the society. A positive change in the society. This may by addressing the discontent. And that is the one of the major objectives of the major purpose of the professional social work. Therefore, it is highly significant and deeply related with each other. Okay, because in the professional social work also, main aim is to make a desired change in the social structure, the society. Okay, by eradicating any unhealthy practice in the society or social evils, to prevent abuse and eradicate any what is exploitation in the society and address any discontent in the society. Okay, and addressing and with the help of the society and by aware in the community and making a positive change by eradicating these social evils and build up a positive change in the society. That is the main aim of the social movement and also the professional social workers. Therefore, social movement is highly significant to the professional social work. And I'm just giving an what is a peripheral information, right? No, and just giving input. And you people, what is a make a keen observation and a keen study about this old terms, okay? All the terms. And next term is social reform. What is social reform? This is another term. It is familiar. It is familiar to us. Okay. And our question is there any significant relation between the social reform and professional social work? Okay. And before that, what is social reform? Social reform also, when we discuss, it is refers to the eradication of any moral or unhealthy or corrupt and wrong practices which threaten the human and social development, right? No? What is a when we hear the term social reform, we will what is a in our life? It is visible in our when we hear about the social reform, it's already visible about some of the social reformers in our country right now. Just for example, everybody will what is know about Rajaram Mohan Roy. What was his contribution in the society? He is called as a social reformer, right? And what was his contribution in making a change in the society? Okay, we still know. And during the 18th century, 1829, we already studied that there was a customs, unhealthy customs among the Hindu religions that is called Sati. No? And what was his work during those days for? What is expressing these issues? Here, he addressed that issue, right now. This addressed that issues and made aware of the people about these unhealthy practices and the social evils, which is affecting harmfully to the society and the human life and the social development, right now. And with the help of with the help of any law, and the sati was banned in India. Okay. That are some other what is some of the examples. Then child marriage. There are a lot of examples are there. We can call these examples are part of a social movement also, the social reform also. Therefore, social reforms refers to the eradication of any moral and unhealthy, correct and wrong practices which threat the human life and social development. Okay, social development. Social reform and social. Okay, social reform is related, like highly significant, and is a part of professional social work, okay, because it is concerned with improving the social functioning of people, right? And social reform also professional social work also. It is concerned with improving the social functioning of the people by introducing a desired change in the social structure and social system by addressing any unhealthy practices, by eradicating any unhealthy practices, okay. Any moral practices or any corruptions in the society. Therefore, so we can say that social reform is highly related significance with the professional social work. As I said just like before, and this term is also very important, and we can see in the previous questions paper also. They're asking about social reform and so, and also about social development. And next term is social network. What is maybe social network? What is maybe social network? And what is the importance of this networking system in social work term? Means when we concern about social network, it is any kind of articulated pattern of connection in the social relations of individual, group, and any other collectives. Means any kind of articulated pattern of connection or relationship between the individuals, relationship between in the group or any organization. That is from a social network. Okay, but in the social case, in the social work profession, the social network refers to the social interconnection among the various voluntary organization. Okay, and the social interconnection relationship among various voluntary organization, and interconnection between various community-based organization, any non-governmental organizations. Okay, those who are working in the same field. Okay, and this is called a social network in the social work. Means the social work, the like-minded organization, whether it is a voluntary organization or CBOs or a community-based organization or NGOs. Okay, those who are working in the field, that means and the same like-minded, those who are working for the people or the society, they will have interconnections. Okay, communication. For what? Just for exchanging the information and exchanging the human resource for performing a better service to the community. Just for example, is the people or the organization working for any community. Okay, just for example, if in our country, if there are a lot of NGOs working for the human rights of for protecting the human rights of TGs, right? Transgenders and the right of the transgenders or any minorities, and they are having a like-minded and they are working for the particular community. Okay, and therefore a different NGOs can share their information. If the one NGO is lacking, if need a services or better services in a particular area, and if they are lacking and that human resource, and another NGO working for the same what is a community, and they have an expert, and this NGO can take the help from another NGO. Okay, can take the support of another NGO, and with the support of the another NGOs, they can work together. And also, the NGOs working for a particular community or a particular group, they can work together for the betterment of the society. And this kind of exchange of information and help, okay, and human resources between different agencies are called a social network system in social work. Okay, therefore, social network, the term social network has an important role in the in social work. These are the three another terms what we discussed about when we social movement, then social reform, and social network. Then another term is that social service. Okay, then social defense. and social security. What is the social service? What is social service? Okay, there is a, when those who are doing service, they also claim that they are social workers, right? No? What is a social service? How it is related with the social work? What is mean by social service? Means social service means any kind of assistance or help provided by the society. Okay, provided by the society to enable its members to optimally actualize their potential to effectively perform their roles. Means the society itself providing assistance and help to the society members, okay, society members to support their, what is the potential to lead a good life, to lead a smooth functioning of the, better functioning of the society. Society itself, society as a state, okay, to give assistance and support to its members to lead a better life, a better social functioning in the society. That is known as a, what is a social service. This is about social service. And how it is related with social work? Is it in relation with social work? Yes, obviously. It is related with social work because social work, what is the main concern of the social work, what we discussed? Is just to promote the human social development, right? And aim to promote a sustainable development by conserving and developing the environment. These are some of the concerns and objectives of the social work, means promoting the what is a human and social development, and also promoting the sustainable development of society. And through the social work, social service also, it is aiming what is the sustainable development of the society, and also the development of human social development. So it is highly significant, highly related to the social service and the social work. And so at the society where we are living, we are getting a lot of help from the government, okay, as from the state for our sustainable development. Okay, there are a number of help and support we are getting from the society for our individual development or the human development. That is why it is highly related with the social work. And next one is social defense. What is mean by social defense? Social defense. What is mean by social defense? Okay. Social defense. Is any, have you heard about the word social defense? What is mean by social defense? Means social defense means protecting the society from various kinds of deviance. Okay. Who will protect the society? Okay, themselves means so society makes some rules. Society makes some measures for protecting the society from any varied kinds of deviance, resulting in any kind of what is a widespread social disorganization, which seriously affect the social functioning. Means society create, society develop, okay, a protective system for protecting the society from any kinds of what is a widespread social disorganization, any kinds of deviance, okay, which leads a disorganization or which may affect seriously to the normal function of the society. Okay, for that, for preventing that, The society makes measures, preventive measures, a protective system to protect the society from any kind of social deviance. That's called as a social defense. There are a lot of laws, rules are there in at our society right now. It is just for example, some for addressing the delinquency, CCLs, children in conflict with the law. We are making some provisions, means some probation systems, and we are giving trainings to the children. We are giving counseling. There are the society furnishes some counseling. There are some laws. There is supportive system to the children. Okay, for what? For what is a protecting the society by protecting the children, preventing the children to not go to any grievance or any other deviance. Then probation system is there. Correctional settings is there. Right now, means probation system is there for preventing the more delinquency in the society by giving a rehabilitation services to the prisoners and training to the prisoners and giving a direction to the prisoners. Is there the society furnishes some preventive system, okay, for preventing any kind of any occurrence of any kind of any delinquencies. And somehow the social work profession has got an important role in that. Many social workers are appointed as a social workers in the correctional settings. Probation officers are there, just for preventing protecting the society. Then when we discuss, look at the concrete definition of social defense. It is a planned, okay, it's a planned, deliberate, and organized effort made by the society, okay, to define itself against the onslaught of any disruptive forces which endangers its law and order, and thereby to impair its social development. That means it is a planned and deliberative effort made by the society, okay, made by the society itself, society itself, against in the onslaught of any disruptive forces, okay, any ill activities, forces which endangers the laws and rules of the society and laws and orders of the society, and thereby to make a positive change in the social and economic development of the society. That is what I want to have to say. Social defense. Just to help you to understand more about the social defense. Okay. And another term is that social security. What is meant by social security? What is the difference between social defense and social security? What is social security? Yes, is there any relation between there are a lot of social security schemes and laws and act are happening nowadays for protecting the society, right? There are, well, therefore It is very important in the case of social work, that social security. What is your social security? Is there any what is there? Any idea about social security? Yes. Just for example, there are schemes. We are living in a society, okay, where having all kinds of amenities which support the social development and human development of the persons. Okay, and also in the society, in our society, there are different kinds of people are living, right? No? There are people with economic capacity. There are people, the sick people are also living. Then vulnerable communities are there. Then what is it? Disabilities are there. Right now, disabilities are there. And also in the vulnerable, nowadays in the vulnerable people are affecting. They are facing lot of problems from the society. Even though we have a lot of laws and rules, but in some cases the rules and laws are failed to attain to help the people, right? Means we are assuring the security to the society, means a society furnishes some security measures, okay, to help the society, but sometimes it is not what is reaching up to that stage. Okay. Means everyone in the society, should get a reasonable and a definite help and recognition in our society. Okay. But ensuring this kind of recognition and help and support to the society people are ensured with the help of the term social security. Okay, and it is a debatable, nowadays it is a debatable term that is the social security functioning in the society or not. Why I am stressing this point is that nowadays, this term has got a lot of importance. Importance means we have a lot of social security measures. Still now, or still then, we are facing the security problems in our society. What is that? A problem against disease, security against disease. Okay. And security against ignorance. Against ignorance. Means in our society. In some other state, we are trying, we are attaining 100% of education. But some other areas in our society, people are not getting an educational facilities, right? And security against some scholar means some other evils, some other social evils which are relating to health and sanitation. Okay, the people in our at present, when we are analyzing in the current situation, we can say that we are not attained a definite kind of security measures in the health practice right now. Because in the day, if happening disease or any what is unhealthy situations, our health systems are not, we cannot say that for 100% has unable to provide health services to the world peoples. Therefore, reaching health services to the people. There are a lot of schemes out there for reaching this kind of health services to the people. Are very important. And also, this is one of the questions in our society. We are all living, but some part of the people are not getting any kind of health services. And for reaching the health services to all people, the government had made some schemes and programs as a part of social security. Then also, another one is about unemployment. Okay, means for solving this for the society, they take measures that providing of employment opportunity to the people. So just for meeting their, just for solving the problem of unemployment in the society. And these are the things, means just those are disease, having a disease for addressing disease, providing medical facilities, those who are having any health issues and providing any health services and health schemes and support system. And also, if any unemployment means economic problems, and providing an employment opportunity to the people to meet that one. Okay, these are all different kinds of security measures furnished by our government, our state, our society. Okay, for the betterment of the social function. Then there are three methods of social security. Okay, there are three methods of social security. That first one is social assistance. Social assistance means giving cash to enable the people to meet their actual needs. In some kind, we'll give an assistance, that is called a social assistance, giving money, cash to the people to attain, to meet their needs. Then social insurance. Social insurance means, in the social insurance, and the beneficiaries are required to make some nominal contribution at first. Okay. And later on, the same beneficiaries are given care and more security, more monetary, getting more monetary benefit. That is social insurance. Just for example, we are investing money in some kind of insurance policy, right? Now, different kinds of insurance policy. What is happening in the insurance? We are the beneficiaries, right? No? So at first, we invest. Okay, we invest some nominal contribution, right? No? And after a particular time, we get the monetary benefit and other kind of service and security measures from the part of social security, that is social insurance. And there are a lot of social insurance system made by different insurance policy and also our government also. The public or social service, that means promoting the social and human development. Through that, promoting the social and human development with the help of different project schemes. These are the different methods of social security. Then, don't make any confusion between the terms social service, social defense, social security, and social welfare. And next, we are going to discuss about social welfare. What is mean by social welfare? We are living in the society, as we discussed just like before, with all kinds of amenities right now. We are having a public transport system, road connectivity, electricity, drinking water, health and sanitization, and what is a wealth, and we are getting houses, all kinds of help, and there are different projects and programs are there for addressing and ensuring this kind of help to the people and to the society right now. And the term social welfare, what's mean by social welfare? That means the so through the social welfare in the state, it is a state, okay, it is state, or it is a condition with regard to a good health, happiness, prosperity, and human development. All kinds of developments means people are attaining, people are getting a chance to live a good life. Just means they are getting a good, health, education, economic health, transport system. Means getting an overall development and okay, which support a smooth functioning and attaining a social development. Means welfare of the people. That's known as social welfare. Means the Dasgupta defined social welfare as social welfare. It is a package of service. Okay, and the entire package of service, social and economic. Okay, it is an entire package of service. Whether it is a package of service or social and economic, that deal with income support, welfare provisions, and social security on one hand. That is termed as social welfare. Means people are getting in society ensuring a package of service which leads a social support and economic, okay, social and economic development. That means that they ensure the support of all kinds of welfare provisions, whether it is a social or economic, any cultural, okay, all kinds of support and welfare to the people. That is termed as social welfare. And the ultimate aim or one of the purpose of social work also to ensure a social welfare in the society. Okay, by providing, by assisting, what a support to the human, individual, group, and society to attain their development, social development. These are this is what is one of the major purpose and aim or goal of social work. Okay, social welfare. This is about social welfare. I think we discussed a lot of terms right now. And the next one is social justice. What is meant by social justice? This is another term which is highly related with social process, social work. And this is one of the objectives and goal of social work, to ensure social justice in the society. What's mean by social justice? What is justice? And when we hear about the term social justice, it is very important to remember the term Justice Krishna here. Okay, he is a former justice. The justice has given a definition. Okay, according to Justice Krishna here in 1980, he has given a definition to the social justice is that it is a generous concept. Social justice is a general concept. It's a generous concept. Okay, it is a generous concept assuring every members of society a fair deal. Okay, assuring every members of the society a fair deal. Means it's a generous concept without any typism. Okay, it's a generous. It should be, it's a generous service, a concept assuring every members of society a fair deal of remedial of injury, injustice, and any kinds of inadequacy or disabilities suffered by members for which he is not directly responsible. Means ensuring justice, if a generous support system, ensuring justice to the people, okay, those who are denying any kind of injustice or injury, any disabilities, okay, any kind of means where he is not directly responsible, means giving help to the old people of the society. And there are a lot of social justice schemes, rules and laws are implemented by our government for the betterment of the society. There are a lot of systems out there for protecting the right of the vulnerable group of people, for protecting the right or ensuring in the justice to the sick people, to ensuring justice to the disability people. There are a lot of disability acts as established, okay, for protecting the right and bringing this kind of vulnerable people to the mainstream of the society, and also addressing the issues of vulnerable group of people. There are a lot of schemes and roles are made. Okay, it is just for protecting the safeguard of the people, and also ensuring equality and freedom to the people. This is about the social justice. And when we discuss about social justice, this is one of the objectives of professional social work, that a professional social worker should stand for justice. He should address any injustice in the society, okay, which is affected, happening in society, and also it is affected by the vulnerable group of people. And the social worker or the professional social worker should address this kind of social injustice, and he should stand for justice, and he is a channel for ensuring justice to the all kinds of people, besides their religion, or besides their geography, or besides their caste, creed, class, no, besides all this kind of, all the people should be treated as equal, and all the people should get their justice. All the people should get their justice, and the social worker should stand for that, to ensuring the social justice to the society. Okay, and therefore it is very important, that important part of professional social workers. And next term is social policy. What is social policy? This is another term. Okay, social policy. What's the use of social policy? When is the need of a social policy? Means it is for just addressing if any change, okay, in the government, the state, make some policies for addressing some issues is any happening. If any particular group of people or any particular group of society needs any help, the state address these issues and make some policies for rendering the services to that particular community, and for making that community to lead a smooth functioning. So social policy, what is the meaning of social policy? It is a course of action. Okay, it is an action adopted by the government, which are related to the social aspects of the action, which are deliberately designed and take improvement of welfare of the citizen. It is an action taken by the government. It is an action taken by the government in a particular situation when it is needed to address, or it is needed to help, give help, it is needed to help a particular group of people or society. It is needed for the development of any particular group of people in the society. If it is any discontent which is affecting badly to the any individuals of the society, and for addressing and for eradicating this all and making a smooth functioning of the society, the government themselves will take an action, okay, to make a policy to ensure that one. There are number of policies in our society which is taken by our government right now. There are different kinds of policies are taken, and later on these policies became what is a schemes, and also these policies became some acts right now. In our government also we can see. Just for example, what is for addressing the unemployment in the rural women, MNRAGA. Now it is an act that it has taken by the government right now. Like that, for addressing the what is a problem of any disability, for addressing the problem of disability, the government has taken some policies for ensuring the right of the people, and also for ensuring the employability of the rural women or rural people. Government has taken some policies, and before it was taken as a part of schemes, now it's become a policy. Then for addressing any kinds of issues in the society, and the government has taken some policy. Means government itself has taken an action. Okay, a government has taken some action against addressing some social issues, for preventing some social issues, and ensuring support and help to the people. Okay, this is about social policy. Okay, then in terms of social policy, we can say that when we analyze the directive principle of state policy, it is already envisaged about the social policy or policy measures. We can say that our articles 38, what are the directive state policies are there? Okay, this is about social policy. These are all the different terms. Okay, prior to that social work. Yes, when we from where we start? We started from voluntary action, charity, right now. Then Ramadan, then social movement, social reform, right? Social network, social services, and social defense, social security, social services, right? Then social justice and social policies. These are all very important part while dealing with the professional social work. Okay. Then we can deal with what is social work. I will just read the sentence of J.P. Anderson. It is a professional service rendered to people, okay, for the purpose of assisting them as individual in group to attain satisfying relationship and the standard of life in accordance with their particular wishes and capacity, and in harmonious with the community. Means it is a professional services rendered to the people, okay, given to the people for the special purpose and aim. What is that? For assisting the individuals or group or community, okay, for helping, assisting them to lead a standardized relationship in the society, to assist the people to lead a standard life in the society, a stable life in the society, and also it will help the society people or group of people or individuals to make a harmonious relationship, okay, harmonious relationship in the society, and through that it aims a personal development, a human development, a society development, and a community development. This is and for that it needs a special kinds of specialized knowledge and skill, and social service is given in a systematic way. And we are going to study social professionals of what is social work detailed and later. Okay. And now, then we can study. And then now I am going to discuss with you about some objectives of social work. Okay, objectives of social work. Purpose and objectives of social work. The first objectives means to facilitate an effective utilization of community resources for their welfare. This is one of the objectives and purpose of the professional social work, means to facilitate effective utilization of the community resources for the welfare. Means help the community people to identify the resources from the community. Okay, means just to facilitate the community people to identify the resources from the community itself and help them to lead a welfare. To lead a welfare state. Means in our community, there are resources are there. Just for example, as a human beings or as an individual, we have a lot of skills and abilities, knowledge, but some kinds we are failed to identify that. But in the case of social work, here it will facilitate or assist the individual or the society or community to identify their own resources. Okay, their own resources. Okay, with the help of the resources the major aim is to a human development or a society development. And another aim of the professional social work is to give assistance to individual. Okay, to give assistance to individual while removing the difficulties which they face in utilizing the basic service of society. Means assistance to the individuals, okay, to find out the solution to for problem solving. And another objective or purpose of social work is that to solve the psychosocial problems of the person. To solve the psychosocial problems of the person. As an individual, we are living in the society and we are facing a lot of, we are influenced genetically and environmentally and a lot of factors. And these factors will affect a person, okay, affect the person positively or negatively. Okay, and if it is affecting the person's, if the environmental factors and genetic factors are affecting an individual's throughout their life, their personal development. Therefore, to identify the psychosocial problems of the person, to help the individual to solve their psychosocial problem. This is one of the main purpose and objectives of social work. Then another important objective of social work is that to solve the adjustmental problems of an individual, to solve the adjustmental problems of an individual or group. Okay, this is very important. We are living in a society, our family, our personal life, our society. It is very hard for us to adjust with the society or our family. In the family life also, there are a lot of adjustmental problems are there. And the person itself, they have some adjustmental problems with their families, their society. And here to solve, to help the person, okay, individually or group, to solve their adjustmental problems. And another purpose or objectives and objective of social work is that to fulfill the humanitarian needs like love, affection, care. Okay, to help the people, to assist the people to fulfill their humanitarian needs, what is fulfill of a person's individuals to live in a what is a love, care, and affections to ensure the individuals, individuals to live in a harmonious life without disrupting any kinds of illegal influences which is affecting from families or adjustmental problems or any kinds of influences from the environment. Addressing this all and helping the person to lead a smooth life and also help the person to develop a behavior management. These are all, this is the main objective and what is the purpose of social work. Then next one, I'm going to I would like to share some code of ethics. Okay, National Association of Social Work is there, and they are giving some core values and ethics. And what are the core values and ethical principles of social work? It is very important. There are six ethical values and principles in social work. And the first one is service. This is one of the core value and ethical principle, core values of social work, service. And ethical principle is that the primary goal of professional social work is help the people in need and address their social problems. Is giving a service to the human and giving a service to the humanity. And so professional social worker should have a service mentality. Okay. Our profession is based on service. Through service, we are attaining or we are focusing and to help the people to address their problems and help the people to solve their problem. Okay, therefore, service, the term service is very important. This is a, very important to, important in professional social work. This is a core value, one of the core value of social work. And next to core value or ethical, core value is social justice. This is another core values and ethical principle of social work is social justice. In social workers challenge the social injustice. Okay, and social work act as a pursue, stand as an agent for social change. This is ethical principle. Social workers challenge social injustice and should not stand for any injustice. Should address the social injustice, okay, and ensure social justice in the society and stand as an agent, as a channel for a positive social change. And another core values and ethical principle is that dignity and worth of the person. This is another core value of professional social work. Dignity and worth of the person means the professional social work field should respect the inherent dignity and worth of the person. This is very important. This is very important ethical core values and ethical principle. Okay. I think after completing the course, you may be going for a counseling. Some of you may be a case worker. And we are working in different fields right now. And we should keep in mind that this is very, very important, that dignity and worth of the people means the person in front of us, maybe from different regions or different backgrounds, but in front of a professional social worker, okay, if the person is coming from any field, the social worker should respect the dignity of that person the worth of the person, and the value of that person, besides the problem. And some says, if there is a disease, if the is a person with any kind of disease, sometime if the doctor will look at the disease, okay, give medicine to that disease. But in the case of social work, we should respect the person as he is. We should respect the value of the person. We should respect and the culture of that person. We should respect in the religions of the person. We should respect the attitude and feelings of that persons. Okay. Treat the person very careful and pay a high respect. Okay. Then only the professional social worker can assure the help and service to the people. And if showing any kind of rapism, it is against the code of ethics, ethical value of professional social workers. And another one is important of human relationship. It is very important. Okay. Recognize the central importance of human relationship. Strengthen the relationship. Professional social workers give importance in making the relationship, strengthen the relationship with the people. Okay. The next one is integrity. Yeah, professor, this is very important. Ethical principles and core values of professional social work is integrity. Yes, behave in a trustworthy. Yeah, professional social workers should be trustworthy and honesty and responsible in providing service or giving assistance to the people or community or society. Okay. Behave in a trustworthy manner in front of the society or in front of the people. Okay. Professional social workers. If once we lose the trustworth, we may not be able to fulfill our profession. We may not be able to render our help and assistance to the needy people. Therefore, it is very important to keep our integrity. Okay, all the professional social workers should have an integrity. This is another ethical principle of social work. That is, integrity means behave in a trustworthy manner. Okay, while providing service to the people or society, and be honesty in service delivery and really make a relationship with the person. Be honesty in respecting the dignity of the person. Be honesty and trustworthy in our service delivery. Okay. And another one is competence. This is another value and ethical principles of social work. That is competence. Means social workers practice within their own areas of competence and develop and enhance their professional expertise. Develop our skills, and update our information. Be competent in the field, in our service delivery. Means update the professional knowledge according to the contemporary. Okay, then only the professional social workers can provide assistance and service to the community. A professional social worker should be competent enough to give service to the society. Okay. These are all about ethical principles and core values of professional social workers. It is very important. What are the core values? First one is service. Okay, that means giving a service to the people, okay, and also help the people to address their social problems. And second one is social justice. Third one is dignity and worth of the person. Another one is importance of human relationship. The purpose of making a good relationship with the person. Okay, that is very important. We strengthen the relationship. These are all other, what is the values, core values. Another important one is integrity. Then competence. These are the core values and ethical principles of professional social work. Then there are another kind of ethical standards are there. This is also very important. Not only the core values and ethical principles, the professional social worker should have some ethical standards while providing service to the society. Okay, we can discuss that. The first one is our ethical responsibility to the client. As a professional social workers, by providing service to the society or the people, or people or individual, okay, and it should be responsible to the client. The person who comes for help in front of a caseworker or a social worker is called a client, right? Now, and here in the social worker have an ethical responsibility to the client. What is that? Ethical responsibility and accountability to the client in service delivery. We should be responsible to the client. Okay. Another one is ethical responsibility to the colleagues. Not only the first one is our ethical responsibility to the client. And next one is our ethical responsibility to our colleagues. Means that we cannot do any kind of rumors, any kind of malpractice, any kind of hammering work, what is the activities to our colleagues. We should respect, means we should keep the core values and ethical, what is the principle, to our colleagues. Okay, while working in the settings, that is very important. We can say that how much do we are, what is a knowledgeable person or skilled person. Some person in settings, collaboration and trustworthy and dignity is very important for the smooth functioning. Therefore, our ethical responsibility, our commitment, our trustworthy, our dignity, and our service and love and care, affection, and our responsibility to the colleagues is very important. Therefore, as a professional social worker, we should not violate any kinds of what is a ill activities settings. And third one is ethical responsibility to practice settings. That is also very important. Ethical responsibility in practice settings, our settings.
Practice settings.
Yes. Practice setting. Settings, okay. Whether it may be a counseling setting, whether it may be a correctional settings, whether working in the hospital, whether he may be working in a company, or whether he may be working in a school or any multinational hospitals, any place, okay. And where we are working, that is our settings, okay. Where we are, where we are working, and our job responsibility are defined. Okay, there we should be responsible to the settings. Then another one is ethical responsibility as profession. Ethical responsibility as profession means we should be competent enough, we should know about our capacities, our knowledge, our limits, and job, our responsibility, okay, and our professional responsibility and our professional competency, our personal objectives, and should work, we should work on that. And don't make any kind of malpractice or imbalance in our profession. Okay. Therefore, our profession is very important. Give due respect to the profession and keep the dignity and worth of our profession. Okay. If we are not keeping the professional values, what if we are this, what is a affect, if we are doing any kinds of activities which is hammering our professions, what will happen? Our professional dignity will go down. Okay. Therefore, as a professional social workers, this is our ethical standards to keep our ethical responsibility as a profession, where we are work, what work we are doing, and at what stage we are. This is very important. This is the third ethical standard. Okay. Another one is social work profession. Ethical responsibility to social work profession. What does it mean that? Social work profession means in the social work, we are following some ethical values, some social work profession. Okay. In the social work profession, we are following some principles. We will learn a little later. We are following a number of principles. We are following the code of ethics. We are following some principles, ethical principles. Okay. And we are having some competency, all things. Therefore, as a professional social workers, we should have keep an ethical standard while maintaining our social work profession. Maintaining our social work profession. Then the last one is our ethical responsibility to broader society. Our ethical responsibility to broader society. If it's right, we are working in a setting. Yeah, we are just for example, we are working in the medical setting, or we are working in a psychiatric setting, or we are working at a HR settings. Okay, but apart from this, we should have a responsibility to the broader society, to the broader society as a whole. Okay, not only to our colleagues or a client or any profession, but we should have a responsibility to our society. Okay, while keeping the values of profession, by keeping our principles. As a professional social worker, we should have a responsibility to society. Means for addressing any social injustice in the society, as we discussed just like before, just for stand for justice in the society, help the society to address any deviance. Okay, and stand as a change agent, stand as a social activist, stand as a social educator, stand as an enabler in the society, and we should have an ethical standard, a responsibility towards the broader society. These are all different ethical standards in our social work profession. Okay. Then we will go to different methods. Just like discuss about different methods of social work. Okay. In professional social work, has six methods. They are pointed out six methods, and in the first year and also in the second year, we are going to deeply studying about different methods of social work. And these methods is one thing which differentiates the social work profession from another curriculum. Okay. And this social work profession, these methods are divided into six. We are going to deal with six methods, And six methods I categorize into two areas. There is primary methods and secondary methods. Okay. There are three primary methods and there are three other secondary methods. And the first one is social casework. Okay. Casework. And second one, social group work. And third one is community organization. These are called the primary methods of social work. Social casework, social group work, and community organization. As termed as primary methods of social work. And another one, social work research. What we are going to study in the sixth paper, social work research, social welfare administration, and social action. What are the things? Social work research, social welfare administration, and social action. These are termed as secondary method of social work. First, we can just to go through the social case work. You know, the social work practice, the social work first dealing with an individual, okay? Then a group of individual group, then society, like that. And social case work is, we already know, what is the case work? Here, we are helping an individual development, okay? We are helping, we are assisting an individual to solve the psychosocial problem of individual. Our aim is to, what is that? Develop an individual development of a person. And according to Ms. Richmond, I will just read the definition of Richmond about casework. According to Richmond, social casework, it is an art of doing. It is an art of doing different things for and with the different people, okay? By cooperating with them to achieve at one and the same time their own and their society betterment. That means social casework, it is an art of doing, it's an art of doing different things, different mode of assistance. Okay, for different people with the different problems. Okay, means this art of doing different things. Okay, yeah, we know we have already studied the principle of social work, means every individual is unique. Okay, means every individual have their own problems. Okay, their own attitude, their own what is that? Knowledge, their own. They are coming from different background. They have their own different. What is feelings and attitudes. Therefore, means it is an act of doing, working with the different people, with the different things, with the different people, by cooperating with them, by cooperating the individuals to achieve in the one, the individual development, and at the same time to achieve the social or society betterment. That is not a social casework. Means helping an individual, okay, individually to solve this problem, to attain the person, to attain his, what is that, goal, and to help the person to solve his problem, and also to help that person to, what is that, adjust or, what is that, to help the person to attain a better life. In the society, and also help the person to make a better society or society betterment. That's not a social casework. We will study detailed about social casework in the second year. Okay. Now it is just for a name's sake. It is given a peripheral data only regarding the social casework. There are some philosophical assumptions behind the social casework. Okay, what are that? Means the first one is that a society has an obligation to help each other. This is one philosophical assumption behind the social casework. Yes? Our society has an obligation to help others. If any individual, any person is facing any problems, if any person is having any adjustmental problem, if any person is having any kind of discomfort, the society, it is the duty of the society to help that person to live a better life. Therefore, as a society member, we cannot keep away from that. It is our duty also to help the persons. Okay. A person, those who are in trouble. Therefore, that is one of the philosophical assumptions. Then another one is human beings are interdependent and it governs their interaction in social group. Means the individuals and we are interdependent. Okay, we are interdependent. We are dependent. What is it? Even though we are independent, but we are dependent in our society. Okay, we are dependent in our society. Therefore, there's a social, through the social casework, main assumption is that through an interaction, okay, through a social interaction, it will help the individuals in the society to help each other. Through that, it leads a social group development. Then another philosophic assumption is that every human being has to be considered as a person with a dignity and person. Just for example, I think your people are working in different fields. Okay, some of you. And if the person is coming in front of us, just for help. Okay, just for, and at the time of counseling, we are just worried if you are a counselor, while at the time of counseling or casework. Okay, and we have to consider, we have to respect the dignity and worth of that person besides their, social background. This is about some philosophical background and it is about historical development of casework in West and India. When we try to study about trace the history of social work, you know, history of social work, the social work profession was started as a part of charity in ancient time, no? Ancient time, then it is developed as some rules in September law in 16 and not born. Then the community organization society has developed, settlement movement has developed like that, no? That is about the development of professional social work, development of professional social work. And by discussing about the history of casework, the early begins in the US, in the West and India, is that in 1843, the AICP, that means the Association for Improving the Condition of Poor. Okay, the Association of Improving the Condition of Poor. This one, that is formed in America in 1843. And the main work of that organization was to approach poor people in the society, in the rural area. Okay, and render the help. Means the main aim is to visit the community, means poor at home, and to give the counseling, and assist the people to obtain employment by providing employment training. The same thing that it is a long history back. Okay, and to assist some material help to the poor people in the society. And by ensuring in the dignity and worth of the people. That was the work of that organization, that is the Association for Improving the Condition of the Poor. Means just to visit the community people and give counseling and employment training program to the people okay, and give another kind of help to the people. And later on, the workers, those who are working at the grassroots level, they were giving training. Yes, at present, they rendered help to all kinds of people without looking their needs. Okay, then after that, they focused on what is the different problems, and they provided help according to that problem. Okay, at first, in the beginning, they rendered help to all people. Okay, this is without analyzing, and later on they analyzed the problems of the people, and they categorized and given help according to the problems. Okay, and this kind of work they started with the help of the special kind of training given to that workers. Okay, and the first professional school of social work was established in New York, okay, in 1898. And with the establishment of that institution, the New York School of Social Work, this started giving training, and that institution have a sufficient large body of knowledge and skill, and they given a training to the people, those who are working, and to the people, and they made a large body of a knowledge system and the skills what is needed for the people, those who are working in the community. And in 1877, the establishment of American Charity Organization Society established. This American Charity Organization Society established in 1877. What is that? Means it is called a COS, Charity Organization Society. In the American Charity Organization Society, they visited the rural area, means poor people, and they gave the council, and they gave training for employment to the people, okay, with the help of volunteers. And these volunteers were called friendly visitors. Okay, these volunteers were called friendly visitors. Under the charity organization society, the volunteers reached the society and work with the people, and this kind of volunteers were known as friendly visitors, and also known as a paid agent. And these volunteers were given specialized training from the institute level. Okay, that is before 1990. And the world, the major development of social casework was revealed during the First World War. Okay, in 1914 and 1917. In 1917, the first book of social casework was published by Mary Richmond. It's known as Social Diagnosis. Okay. Social Diagnosis. And during 1970s. And during the First World War, the social casework has an important role. It played an important role that in the during the World War, the people were lost their relatives, and many people were injured and handicapped. Some of them lost their economic level, some of the people lost their relatives, and all the people were in a dilemma, and in the bad conditions. These volunteers were visited in the field and given support to the people who affected the World War. Okay, then in 1920, by focusing on the book of social diagnosis of Mary Richmond, the Sigmund Freud has contributed a great support through a psychodynamic development of persons. Okay, that is in 1920. This caseworker adopted the new psychoanalytic approach to understand the client and their problems in more deliberately, with the help of the psychoanalytic theory of Sigmund Freud. Means in the first year, as a, during the war or before, people in the so class caseworkers were supported with the help of a social diagnosis. Okay, and later on, with the help of the psychoanalytic approach, in the social caseworker adopted or social caseworker understand the client's problems in, and also they could help the psychosocial development of the person. And in 1930, there was a economic depression happened in the world due to the First World War. People were found very difficult to meet their life because of economic problems. And it made a large depression in the society, okay, after the First World War. And those times, the social caseworkers provided a major help to the people and to the community through the government public assistance program and counseling. Okay, and 1940, and after 1940s, there was a in the during the Second World War, the social casework has also entered in the field, and also the term of social casework has changed, and they developed, they transformed the change with the help of theory and practice. Like that, and the present conditions, social casework and developed as a professional services in all field, and it developed a full-fledged, okay, and its applications became different settings, and many research has taken place in the field of social casework. And social casework has got an important applications in the medical settings, the family settings, and the correctional settings, the school settings, in all kinds of settings. These are the history when we trace the social casework from in the USA and India. Okay, and India, the social casework profession was started as a professional service in 1936 at TIS, Tata Institute, now it's known as Tata Institute of Social Science in Mumbai, as a professional curriculum. This is about the development of social casework. And next section, we will discuss on this class and if anybody having any kinds of queries, you can just ask within 2 minutes. Do you have any doubts related with the topic? We will be having a discussion on next class, the remaining part. I think you all people have completed your assignments, and you are looking forward for examination, and also looking forward to your field work, I think.
Yes, sir. So do you know about the plan for the field work this year? Because I think it's already reaching to the Clement examination, right?
Yeah. Normally, it should be completed with the exam, but during the COVID-19, you keep on connect with the university. Okay, site university. I think last year, university has sent one notification about the field work guidelines that instead of working at the field, is to work in the online session on last year, okay, in 2020. And this year, I don't know what is going to happen. As I keep connection with the your website of the university, it will display there the guidelines, okay.
Okay.
And connect with your study center also regarding the field work, okay. I do these two in the parallel. Really, well, connect with the study center and also keep a connection with your university site.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sir, I would like to know when do we have to submit the fees for the examinations June, in the June?
I think.